Snoop!
What's up, G? How you doing, love?
Thanks for being here.
Oh, man, thank you for having me. Happy New Year to you, too.
Happy New Year?
Yeah, last week was Rosh Hashanah, the Jewish holiday.
That's right. The high holidays.
Mm-mm. In more ways than one. Can you dig that?
Wait a minute. How does Snoop celebrate Rosh Hashanah?
Gin and Jews.
Gin and Jews?
Like I said, gin and Jews.
Mazel tov. Join in, Jay. On TBS.
You ready for some Snoop? He's a legend. He has sold over 30 million albums. My first three-time guest, the Dog Father himself, Snoop D-O-double-G. This goes right here for as long as I'm here. Snoop D-O double G
is in the building.
Wait, I've never had a legend like you on the show. 30 million plus, but chilling with rabbis. Everybody's got crews, but
I mean, you know me. I'm international with it. I'm able to move, groove, and you know, get in where I fit in.
Okay, let's all congratulate Snoop. California Girls, the biggest song of the summer.
I want to thank Katy Perry for having enough, you know how to reach out to Snoop Dogg and make it official by bringing us two together. She's a beautiful person. It's a great song.
She is, and talented, man. What's it like to work with her? Is she cool?
It's very hard. It's very easy to work with her.
Let me tell you this. If you think that's hard, I found it hard to watch the video. Check this out. Here's a little bit. In that video is beautiful. That had to be fun. What is that? That's not work, Snoop. What do you call that?
It's like, I should have been an octopus. I needed some more hands. And it was a lot of fun, like a kid in a candy store.
But you know, man, you fit in so many places. I mean, that song is great, but when you hear Snoop on it, it's just talk about cupcakes. It's icing on the cake.
And you do know that.
Yeah, right. Is that going to happen more, you think? More collaborations that someone else reached out to you?
Yeah, you know, I mean, my music has always been for people, you know what I'm saying? So the more people that want to do records with me, I'm open for it, you know what I'm saying? You know, this is what I do, George. I make people happy. I make people dance, and my music represents that.
You truly do. You truly do.
The flow.
You got the flow.
Come on, man.
You got the flow. Justin Bieber?
I got Bieber fever. I mean, Snoop. He is. He's the thing, man. I mean, I concede. He's the one.
He is. You've seen a lot of talent. You've seen a lot of young rappers come up in the game.
Yeah.
You, when all the people that you hung with.
Yeah.
And he, tell me, he's got.
He's got star power. He's got know-how. He looks good. He's young. He's the one.
Cool. All right. Now, here's, let's talk about this. California is about to vote on marijuana.
Say why?
Yeah. we're about to vote. If it passes, do you think it changes California?
Wow. I really believe it would take California to another level.
It's going to take California to an all-time high.
Definitely. We'll be able to fry the friendly skies at all times.
Well, you know, listen, a lot of people ask, you know, it gets a bad rap. But I think for people who are sick for medicinal purposes, people who are sick,
yeah.
People who are in pain,
yeah.
People who can't eat,
yeah.
People who just love to watch TV.
Yeah. I mean, It's the best piece of medicine that they've ever created. You know, I used to go to the store and buy Anacin and Bufferin and Bayer, but it's nothing like this medical marijuana, man.
Wait a minute. Snoop broke out with Anacin. You know how long he's... I heard somebody say Anacin.
My bad.
And they got different blends, man. They got blends that make
you... Blueberry, strawberry, purple, OG Kush. They even got Obama Kush. See, but that's when you blowing presidential. You know what I'm saying? Everybody don't do it presidential. You know what I'm saying? Then they have the executive branch. Then they have the, you know, the House of Representatives. They got, you know what I'm saying? It is what it is.
It's deep.
It's real deep. It's
yes,
like a
we
cookie
cannabis.
Jar. Yeah, it's like a cookie jar. You got to go in and come out and then...
Okay, here's what I love. I go into 7-Eleven and I see a Snoop 7-Eleven cup. I thought I was hallucinating, man. Check this out. So from explain to me, it's, and it says youth football. Explain to me the cup.
Snoop. What it is, it's a Snoop Youth Football League cup, and it's which 7-Eleven is called Cup for a Cause. So what they do is they donate 20 cents to my youth football league every time someone goes in and purchases a coffee cup. And it's a cause where you got a celebrity, you got 7-Eleven, and you bringing it all together to bring some awareness to a great cause, which is my Snoop Youth Football League.
Yes, your football league is saving kids and changing kids' lives, and it's football. It's
yes,
a good
sir.
Game. They want to play for you, and actually you're thinking about taking it to Chicago. That's how successful it is.
Chicago. I want to take it all over the world, but Chicago is like a place that really needs it because there's a lot of violence and a lot of negativity. So what I like to do is take my football programs to the inner city where it's a lot of violence, and I give the kids another option other than gangbangers and violence, and football is a great way to do it.
That's a good one. To go to 7-Eleven and get your Snoop. So stick around. When Snoop and I come back, we're gonna blow your mind. So don't move. Snoop Dogg. Hey, all the people that you've been with, Dre, Eminem, Katy Perry, I saw you and David Beckham together.
Yeah.
How you guys hook up?
I was a fan of soccer, going overseas, watching soccer matches and whatnot. And, you know, I did a show called Live 8 in London once upon a time, and he came to the show, and I ran over there to meet him and became friends with him. You know, if I like somebody, I'm going to go over to him and say, I like you. Can I get your number? Can I hang out with you? And he obliged, and we've been hanging out ever since then.
He's cool. That's cool.
Like me and you. You know how we
do. Come on, man. You know how we got. What do you guys do together? Wait a minute. Can I say, have you ever bent one with Beckham?
We like to bend them a lot.
All right. Snoop, go
yes,
ahead. So now here's what I think is a big thing, man. Because we all got kids. Beck's got kids, and you got kids. Cybercrime on the computer.
Yeah, man. A lot of that. I'm dealing with a company called Norton, and what we did was we put together a contest where if you send in a song about cybercrime, you can win a ticket to one of my shows and get a chance to get with my management and see what it is. But what's happening is it's a lot of people stealing music off of the internet and taking names and credit cards. So we just want to make the awareness, you know, that it is happening and we're not cool with it. You know, they stole my music before in the past and put it out before without my permission, and we're here to fight it.
It happens a lot, and it's not right. So everybody go to hackiswack.com, submit your video.
Yeah.
And, you know, we all go to 7-Eleven, get your Snoop cup, and help all the kids.
Yes, sir.
Come on, Snoop. So, now I'm a fan. I used to tell you that when I was back in the day, when I was in the clubs, I would bump Snoop every day before my shows. And there's one question that I've always wanted to ask you.
I like that.
Uh-oh, Snoop.
What's that? What does that music mean?
You know what that music means?
What does it mean? What does it all mean?
It means it's time to blow these people's mind. Here's something that will blow your mind. Men are 6 times more likely to be struck by lightning than women. So ladies, quit complaining. We make more money than you.
That was mind-blowing, George. Did you also know that penguins are monogamous? Which is one of the reasons there aren't any prostitutes at the South Pole. One of the reasons.
It would take 7 Empire State Buildings stacked one on top of the other to measure the Gulf of Mexico at its deepest point. But it only takes 1 Empire State Building to measure the Empire State Building.
Now, the Great Wall of China is one of 2 human structures viewable from space. The other one is this stapler.
Experts say it's more difficult for overweight women to have children. Whoever did that research apparently has never been to a Kmart.
Rice paper doesn't have any rice in it. And crepe paper doesn't have any crepes in it. Wallpaper doesn't have any walls in it. When will paper stop lying?
According to scientists, cat urine glows under a black light. According to me, those scientists have way too much time on their hands.
Let me think. 82% of glaciers have disappeared in Glacier National Park, Montana. Scientists blame global warming. Montana State Police blame black people.
The condom was invented in the 1500s, but Latinos didn't start using them until the 1980s. And that's all the time we have to blow your mind. Everybody, Snoop Dogg! For an exclusive Twitter Q&A with Snoop, go to LopezTonight.com. When we come back, Bethany Frankel!